Hey there, Service Pros. This is Christian from the Workiz product team. In this video, we're going to talk about how to customize your team's roles and permissions in Workiz. Workiz was designed with companies like yours in mind. We get that not everybody on your team needs as much access to the software as your administrators. That's why your account comes equipped with four different roles that you can assign to members of your team right out of the box: admin, manager, dispatcher, and tech. An admin is a highly authorized role with no restrictions. A manager is a fairly authorized role with a few restrictions relating to user management and account settings. A dispatcher is similar, with restrictions relating to your account settings and some reports. A tech is a fairly limited role with few permissions, designed for field techs who just need to access jobs and log the work that was done. As mentioned, each role comes with a unique set of permissions designed to only show your team members what they need to see. But Workiz allows you to alter the permissions for specific roles, and even create new roles from scratch to meet your company's needs. Let's show you how to do that. One thing to keep in mind before we get going is that roles can only be assigned to paid users on your account. Anybody listed as a subcontractor on your team cannot be assigned to a role. First thing I want to cover is how to change a user's role. Your user's role will be whatever you chose when first inviting them to your Workiz account. Changing it after the fact is pretty simple though. Go ahead and select Team from the sidebar navigation. Next, select the user whose role you want to update. From the profile page, under User Details, select the field for User Role and choose whatever role you want to assign to them. Now let's focus on how to customize the permissions associated with a specific role in your account. From the navigation bar at the top of the page, select the cogwheel and then select Settings. Under Users and Roles, select Roles and Permissions. You'll see all of your roles listed here. Go ahead and select the role you want to update. The permissions for this role will be categorized into three different tabs: Actions, Reports, and Advanced. From allowing a user to see messages in the message center, view client information, add new jobs, or view and manage your company's inventory, there are a lot of different capabilities you can permit or restrict from here. You'll know a capability is being permitted if the toggle switch is green. Likewise, a capability is being restricted if the toggle switch is gray. You can also fine-tune the permissions for this role from the Advanced tab, which allows you to limit the user based on service areas, other users, or job status. Hit save once you're done. Last thing I want to cover is how to create a new role from scratch. Pretty simple. Just hit the Add New Role button right here, give the role a name, and then go into the role settings to configure the permissions you want to apply. Keep in mind that any new role you create will automatically have all the permissions enabled by default. And that's it. You're all set to start customizing your team's roles and permissions. Feel free to subscribe to this channel for all the latest on how Workiz can help your business grow. And as always, if you have any questions, we're here to help. Thanks for watching.